Can anyone hear me? Can you see me? Why is everyone frozen? Getting a better Wi-Fi signal for Zoom is a real art. So this tutorial, which is the final tutorial in the series of three for Zoom, we will be talking about how to get a better Wi-Fi signal. My name's Simon, and this is Computer Tutoring. Before we get started, if you haven't already done so, click on that subscribe button and click on that little notifications button so you don't miss a thing. Obviously, we're bringing out tutorial videos all the time on a wide variety of subjects. And if you have something in particular that you'd like us to cover, or just have a look at or analyze or review, then just put it down in the comments below. Now, we at Computer Tutoring also cover a wide variety of training subjects. So please check out our website. If you're an Instagrammer or a Twitterer, then please check us out there. It would be lovely to hear from you. All right, so first of all, it's worthwhile finding out what you've signed up to. You know, sometimes people will be complaining about their broadband, about it being so slow, and they find that, well, you know what, you're paying the minimum amount. So Papi always said, you pay peanuts, you get monkeys. I've signed up to BT. We're based in London. And I've got to say that working from home, I've discovered that the internet hasn't been maybe as reliable as it is in the training rooms, basically, and offices. So this is the package at the moment that we've got. So we've got an unlimited use. We've got access to BT accounts. That's great. So you can go anywhere around London and pretty much you've got your own wireless hotspot. You can take your iPad out and you don't need internet access because they're everywhere, which is quite good. I didn't realize I had 200 gigabytes of cloud storage as well. I must make sure I take advantage of that. So let's just have a look at speeds as well here. It's normally our download speed will be 72 to 73 Mbps. If you want to understand more about the technology and the phraseology, look at another YouTube video, yeah? Basically here, the bigger the number, the faster it's going to be. So I should expect 72 to 73 on a download speed, and the upload speed is 17 to 18. We will need both of these to be good if we're wanting to work with Zoom. My minimum guaranteed download speed is 68. A lot of companies like BT, they guarantee a minimum download speed and a minimum upload speed. So if that's the case and you're getting nowhere near that, make sure you contact them. Ask for at least a reduction or at most a refund. So what should I do next? Well, the next thing you should do is literally go to your router and plug your computer, your laptop, or whatever it is you're using directly into the router. And then you want to test your speed. So let's go and do that. Okay, so I've downloaded the Speedtest app from the Microsoft Store. I recommend that you use the app. So I'm going to run a speed test on the computer now. So if I click on go, and now it's going to run a ping test. And it's going to look at my download speed. Now, I paid for 72 to 73. Let's see what it brings me. 74. Oh, we've got 75, right? So 74.46 megabits per second. Let's have a look at the upload speed. I've got 18.66. Yeah. Oh, 18.66. That's really good. With a ping speed of 5 milliseconds. Anything under 20 is really good there. So that's great with a test. It looks like I've got a good download speed, well good enough for Zoom, and an upload speed as well, which is well good. And then the 5 milliseconds ping, which is basically what's known as the latency. The lower, the better, to stop freezing happening in Zoom. Great, so I know that many people don't rate the Speedtest app. I've looked and a couple of people have given it some low reviews, but I find that with the app, you tend to get a little bit more accurate results. And the Speedtest do acknowledge that the website version of Speedtest and the app is a little bit different. And Speedtest do, by Ookla, they do recommend that you download the app. And that's what I've done so, and we've seen the results. So let's have a look. Now, this is all about Wi-Fi, okay? So firstly, check the speed test for my computer. Let's have a look and see what the speed test is here. So let's have a click on go. Okay, so I've done the test now with my laptop. I'm a couple of rooms away from the Wi-Fi router. As you can see, my download speed is 72.55 and my upload speed is 17.86. So it's just a couple, you know, of megabits per second lower than it would be if I've connected to it. And you can see my ping is a couple of milliseconds more. So I've got a little higher, what's known as latency. So let's just talk a little bit about this here. So I've got my latency here, and I've got my download, and I've got my upload. Now, when it comes to Zoom, what are the requirements? So let's just actually go to the Zoom site. So I've got, let's just go up here. And as you can see, I've gone to the links, and I'll put the links in the support page below. So I'll give you, there's a support page below. But as you can see here with the links here, this is the recommendations for just standard Zoom meetings. So if I swap back to my speed test here and have a look, and I can see that these here are well within the parameters for my Zoom call. Let's just go back, shall we? Let's have a look here. And then it says, if I want to use the HD video requirements, where we turn on the HD button in Zoom, I'll require a little faster speed, 1.8 Mbps up and down, and also for sending as well, basically. So yeah, and again, those are well within the parameters. And when it goes on to group calling, you've got multiple. So if you're in a meeting with a lot of different people, you'll need a quite slightly higher requirements, basically. So a slightly higher speed. So what does this mean? Let's swap us back to this speed test here. So the download speed is basically how fast your computer can get information. And you'll need that, and so for instance, when you're downloading like movies maybe, or you're downloading bits of software, or you're downloading things from OneDrive or file sharing, that's what that is there. But you'll also need a good upload speed as well. So you can see mine there is 17, that's great. And you've got the ping there. Basically, if your ping is higher, you'll get what's known as a higher latency, which causes the freezing. So all of you gamers out there, you will know the consequences of a high latency. Nobody will want to be on your team, because even though you might be fantastic at the game and your reaction time might be lightning fast, the reaction from your internet connection is not so fast. So you'll end up having glitchy graphics, basically, and not getting the best out of the game. And maybe you'll already be you might already have been eliminated for the game and you won't even know it. So I'm with BT, and on the back of the BT router that's given, I get a little plastic card I can slide out from the back. And on that, there is an admin password and an address to the router. Type that in and you'll be amazed at the information your router will give you about your internet connection and who's using it. Let's have a look. Okay, so I've taken the liberty to slide my little bit of plastic out. And let's have a look and see what it's new. So I'm going to open my browser just here. And at the top, I'm going to type in my number. There we go. And it tells me. You can look these numbers up online as well. They're quite standard, these numbers here. Great. And now when I type that in, I get access to my BT router. Here I can see here, and there's certain things that I've done with this router so that I can get a better internet connection, and I'm just going to talk through a few of them. Now, if I want to make any changes to this one, so say for instance I click on the wireless here and I think, yeah, I want to change some settings, I'm going to click on change settings, it's going to ask me for my password. And if you look on your card, there, you'll see the password, which I'm not going to give you. So let me just type that in and be sure I've got the password right. And now I have access to my router settings. So at the moment, I've got separate bands. So if I switch that off here, you see I've got the buttons here. I can do this one here. Yours will probably be off. So what I'm just going to do is I would switch separate bands on. So now I have the separate 2.4 and the 5 gigahertz bands there. That's great. Now, most of the modern BT routers, in fact, most modern routers come with two bands on them. In the olden days, when people were first getting Wi-Fi internet, oh, it's wonderful, I can connect without wires. 2.4 gigahertz was the only one that you could get. This frequency is unregulated. Basically, they're radio waves everywhere. Waves are going everywhere. And those radio waves are shared by so many different devices. Just drag in here a little page from Wikipedia of what type of devices we've got. We've got baby monitors, we've got wireless speakers, different types of video devices here. Obviously wireless networks, some toys as well, garage openers, some radars, smart power meters, wires, it goes on, even microwaves. And what's more, it only has a limited amount of channels. Well, what I mean by channels, we could talk about channels on your TV set. Just think of 2.4 gigahertz in the days when you only had channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, ITV, I suppose, and channel 4. I remember, wow, that's going back. I don't remember too much, but back in the day when channel 4 was released, it was a revolution until you actually watched the thing. So there is a limited amount of channels that everyone and their mothers are using. As you can imagine, there's a lot of interference. So enter 5 gigahertz. 5 gigahertz is a newer technology which allows a greater number of channels, which means that your router is more likely to find a free channel. If all of that seems a little bit much for you, literally what you need to go to do, just click on the separate bands. So you split it to 2.4 and 5 gigahertz. I can see here, I can change the name as well. Once you have separated the bands, if you go down to the bottom here, you will see your internet connections here. So at the moment, this one here is my 2.4 gigahertz and my 5 here is at the bottom. You want to get as many devices as you can onto the 5 gigahertz band. What are the downsides? Well, even though 2.4 gigahertz is an older technology, the radio waves go further. They can penetrate the thick walls. So if you are living in a house with lots of thick, solid walls, and you are a few rooms away from the router, go for the 2.4 gigahertz. If, however, you are in the same room as the router or it's nearby, go for the 5 gigahertz. I've looked at a lot of different YouTube videos and online forums, tips and tricks and techie tips. And if you can get a good 5 gigahertz connection, go for that one. So now that you've switched over to 5 gigahertz, and you can see this one here, and you go and you can connect to 5 gigahertz on this down here. So if you would click and connect to the 5 gigahertz, you would use your usual password you use to connect to your Wi-Fi. What else can you do? Well, once you've got access to your router, you can also click on the My Network button here. And then what that will do is that will give you an idea of who's connecting to the internet through your router, what basically everyone's doing in your house. So I can have a look here on my Ethernet connection here, and then if I go down, I've got a computer called Beast, which is one of our main computers here, because it's a big beast of a computer, and that's going there through port 2. So that's connected. Basically, I think there's a Zoom session going on that computer just now. I've got a couple of others as well. I've got like a desktop one here, somebody that was, I think used from my house before, but you can see it's not currently connected. I have my Galaxy S8 and there's a Galaxy S9. And you can get an idea of how much internet all of them use as well. If I scroll down, where's my TV? Look, see how much internet my TV uses, you know, and I put that on the 5 gigahertz as well. So if you want to make sure your Zoom meeting is as smooth as possible, or your Zoom training session is as smooth as possible, remove as many devices as you can. The 2.4 gigahertz, that one is very, very crowded. Everyone is trying to get in on that. So it might be that you are trying to share the same channel as your neighbor. How do you know? So if you notice on the channels, I have smart channel here and I have smart channel here. So if you live in the middle of nowhere, basically, this probably won't be an issue. However, if you live in an area, your network neighborhood is crowded, you might want to change your channel from smart to one that is pretty much empty all of the time. How do I do that? What I will suggest here is called NetSpot. So I'll give you the link down below so you can download NetSpot. It comes in a free and paid for edition. For this one here, I'm going to go just through the free edition. It's all that I really need. So I'm going to click on the discover bit here, and then it will scan the networks in the neighborhood and see how busy it is. So let's have a look and see how busy our one is here. Now, I know that this is mine, is the 60WQ. This is my network just here, so I can see that's my 2.4, and that's my 5. It's really the 2.4 gigahertz I'm interested in. So what I can do here is just to see which is the competitor. So I've got that 5600. Let me just tick these ones here. There's some competitors there. And I'm going to click on this channels bit just here. You know, to bring this box up again, just to really show you, all I would do is just double click on any of these here. Now I can see the 2.4 channels. And then any ones that I want to see, let me just untick all these standard BT ones here, because these are the public ones. And your BT say that you will always get priority over the public ones, basically, because BT, the way that they can give internet access all over London, basically, is because your BT box shares internet access with the general public. Okay, so just be wary of that. Great, so here's my competitor here, and I can see that this one here is on channel one. Yeah, so I can see here is on channel one. In fact, if I look just at the top here, I can see that's channel one. Yeah, and so mine over here at the moment is channel six. So I've kept this on smart, which is quite good. So if it's busy on one channel, it will automatically switch to the other channel. But if your router doesn't have that capability, you might need to go back in. So let's just do that to the router. Click on the channel just here and then change the channel. I've only got three options, channel one, channel 6 and channel 11. So I can use channel 6 and 11. If I went back to my NetSpot, you can see here, I could use 6, which I'm on at the moment, or I could use 11 up here. It doesn't seem to be much going on around here that's going to be too strong. Yeah, I've got a couple down here. There's these couples here. I can have a quick look, see the Sithy Sack or whatever they are there. So if I have a quick look, oops, go back to 6, I can see, oh well, they are actually using channel 11. So I just might need to be a little bit careful with that, but their level is quite low, so it should be that my internet will be, you know, powerful, you know, it shouldn't interfere with it too much. However, 6 is nice and empty. If I click on my channel here, have a look down and have a look where 6 is. It looks like I'm the only one really using 6. There is a skybox actually just here. Let me just check that one here. And I can have a quick look, see. But that power, you know, is a lot lower, you know, here than mine just there. That's great. So I might watch out for this one because this looks quite a little bit stronger. So I would then remain on channel number 6. I hope that all makes sense. But basically, you want to make sure that your channel is on its own. Now, I will say there is no such thing as a perfect Wi-Fi signal. Even if you are sitting right next to the router, there will be outages. There will be problems with your service provider. Generally, what I find is if there's no internet at all, I know it's a problem with the internet service provider. Great. So I hope you've got something out of the tips. If you have, give us a thumbs up. It really means a lot. If you haven't already done so, click on subscribe and click on notifications, as there will be more tutorials coming out on different subjects. If you're on Instagram or on Twitter, give us a shout out. We'd love to hear from you. And I just hope that everyone's okay, and want to say thank you so much for watching.